Hello. Today again, I'm with a very special person. He's a very senior Congress leader from Kerala and Minister of State for Labour and Employment. Yes, I'm with Sri K. Suresh. Welcome to my show. On skill development, Government of India is having a target. Target is to train at least 500 million people by 2022. What your ministry is doing on this?
Our ministry means Labour and Employment Ministry is the nodal ministry of this skill development.
Right.
We are taking a lot of initiatives to skill development throughout the country.
Right.
So 50 crores are our target for 2022.
Yes.
As far as the Labour Ministry is concerned,
right,
1 crore. Our estimate target is 1 crore.
Different ministries having different target, and yours is 1 crore.
Yes, in Labour Ministry is 1 crore.
Right.
So we have already started our initiatives because in India we have a lot of potentials.
Right, right.
Our youth is there. Mm-hmm. So in international market and Indian market in future there are large scale opportunities coming.
Yes, yes, true.
So the
true.
Problem is we don't have a skilled youths for that employment.
True.
So our government, UPA government, has decided to train the skilled youths for the employment potential.
True.
So therefore the UPA government has decided to 2022 we have to achieve 50 crores skill levels.
Right, okay.
So therefore in different ministries, Labour Ministry as well as other ministries also have a target to achieve this to 2025 50 crores.
If I ask what kind of initiative you are taking?
Yeah, we have a skill development centers.
Right.
And also we are developing and we are modernizing our ITs.
Okay.
And also we are promoting the individual or organizations,
right,
those who are ready to conduct the skill development centers.
Right, right.
We are also promoting them. Sure. We are helping them. So we some are giving financial assistance.
Some kind of PPP mode, I guess.
Yeah, PPP also there.
Yeah.
The ITs, you know, in India now many of the blocks there is no IT.
Right.
So we are focusing that every block, at least one IT should be there.
Okay.
Then only we can achieve the target.
Okay.
So this IT, not only in the government sector,
right,
we'll, if it is necessary, we will go for the PPP model.
Right.
We will take the help from the private partnership also.
Okay. Right.
Then
right.
only we can achieve the government of India alone to achieve this skill development.
Okay.
So we have to search the other
new partners.
Other partners.
Okay.
Like PPP model.
Yeah. Before going further, it's time to watch a special report on Sri K. Suresh.
Kodikunnil Suresh is Minister of State for Labour and Employment. He's a member of the 15th Lok Sabha representing Mavelikar constituency of Kerala. This is the first time he's being elected to Lok Sabha. Earlier, in 1989, 1991, 1996 and 1999 general elections, he represented Adur Lok Sabha constituency. He was born in Kodikunnil, Thiruvananthapuram. He did his graduation and passed his LLB from Government College, Thiruvananthapuram. Bureau Report, Lok Sabha TV.
Existing ITIs all across India. If you see the situation over there, things are not pretty good.
Yes.
You need some kind of investment.
The existing ITIs are running very, very old courses.
Right.
That courses are, many of the courses are not relevant now.
Yeah.
Now the country has to change. The employment trend is also changed.
Yeah.
So the international labor market also, employment and this also changing. So whatever we need in the present situation,
right,
and whatever we need in the future future.
Okay.
So we have to train that.
We
have to understand the future opportunity and also present condition. Then we have to train such a skilled area.
Right.
So therefore, we have to give a special focus to the ITs.
Okay.
So that ITs, whatever the courses are relevant in the future, we are giving, for example, automobile unit.
Right.
Automobile unit, one of the
biggest sector,
sector, yeah, in the country,
right,
and also outside country,
right.
So we are giving importance to the automobile,
right,
industry,
right, right.
So the IT is in with the help of the private partnership and the World Bank, other, okay, financial agencies,
okay,
we are going to modernize the ITs,
okay,
we are giving new courses,
okay,
which are the relevant for the market,
okay,
for the employment opportunity, we,
right,
are giving,
right,
that courses, and also we are giving assistance to the ITs,
right, right,
the state government, okay, and also private ITs also we are giving to financial assistance.
Mr. Minister, what about this group of youth, if they are trained, for example, in automobile industry, in somewhere in ITI, is there any plan, because lots of other ministries are planning on this, is there any plan from your ministry that, okay, to fund them if they want to start a garage, for example, from Government of India, from Labour Ministry, any kind of fund management, some kind of help to them?
Yeah, of course, we are giving all the help to all the ministries. So the regarding these skill developments, as I said earlier, the Ministry of Labour and Employment target is 1 crore, and also other ministries also given target. If they
after training, I'm talking about after training, if they want to start a garage, for example, and they need some kind of fund, 50%, 50 youth people, they got training in automobile industry over there in ITI, and after that they want to start their own,
yeah,
something. Is there any plan from your ministry,
yeah,
that to provide some kind of fund to
that
them?
Point.
Please,
I'm coming that point.
Please.
Regarding the target of each ministry. Fix up a target.
Right, okay.
So, Labour Ministry, 1 crore.
Okay.
Other ministries also have a target.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
if the automobile industry, some group of the trained skilled
people
want to assistance,
right,
then who, automobile ministries under heavy industry ministry,
mm-hmm,
in India,
yeah,
we are automobile industry is,
right,
coming,
yes,
under,
yes,
heavy industry.
Yeah.
That ministry, concern ministry.
Okay, okay.
So, concern ministry has to help the group.
Okay, that's
so Labour Ministry can help all the groups.
Right, right.
So
got it.
Those groups are related to which ministry?
Okay, okay.
So
okay,
automobile industry is under Ministry of Heavy Industry.
Okay.
So Heavy Industry Ministry can utilize their fund to provide these
groups. It seems very comprehensive.
Yeah, other ministries also, Petroleum Ministry and Social Justice Empowerment Ministry,
right,
Women and Child Love, they are having their own fund.
Okay.
So if skill development is directly related to such that ministry, they can that ministry can help the this skill development group.
Okay, Suresh ji, you know, employment exchange, you want that your ministry want that it should become an information hub. What exactly you people are doing on this?
Now our employment exchanges are only name registration process is going on. There is no proper utilization giving to unemployed youth in the employment exchanges.
Okay.
So now the employment is only name registration.
Okay.
Those who want employment,
right,
that registration is only going in the employment exchange.
Right, right, right.
So we are spending huge amount for the employment exchanges functioning, and also salary, other thing we are giving spending for the employment exchange day to day functioning.
Okay.
But the result is there is no good result from the employment exchange.
True.
So our
effort,
yeah, our aim is,
yeah,
employment exchange has to convert into the career guidance centers.
Okay. Okay.
So one unemployed youth came to employment exchange, he should understand where is the job availability,
right,
where he can apply for the employment,
okay,
either in government sector,
right,
and private sector.
Right. Right.
So our employment exchanges,
right,
should be converted into the career guidance bureau.
Okay, okay, okay.
Then only,
okay,
the unemployed youth can understand in that employment is available in this organization,
right, right,
or that enterprise.
So how you will do that? Are you having any kind of plan to train people who are there in employment exchange so that they should understand what exactly is happening there, all across the globe or all across in India, so that they should become a good advisor to the potential candidate?
Yeah, we are going to modernize the employment exchanges.
Okay.
We are getting assistance to the outside agencies also, okay. Like CIA, ASSOCHAM, and this FICCI, like that. They are the employment generating agencies. We can discuss with them also. So whatever in private sector, whatever the employment opportunities available, they can also inform the employment exchange. So the employment, this career guidance, now we are calling career guidance bureau, can give information to the unemployed youths.
It's time to go for a very short break. Please stay tuned. Left parties, they are losing their ground in West Bengal, but the story is not same there in Kerala. Why?
Normally in Kerala, backward classes and scheduled caste is the backbone of CPM.
Yes.
Now they have changed their mind. They are coming to Congress side.
Mamata Banerjee, I guess, is very aggressive. I compare Mamata Banerjee with any other leader, Congress leader, there in Kerala.
Kerala is entirely different because Mamataji's style is different. Kerala, our Congress party style is entirely different.
There was some issue related with caste certificate you have provided. What was that?
So last four election, I have the same caste certificate I have submitted to returning officer. That time they have not challenged. So this time I don't know.
Welcome back. We are in talks with Sri K. Suresh. Minimum wage. Government of India is saying that anybody who is in rural India managing 30 rupees or 32 rupees per day, he should not be considered as poor. Your ministry, you as minister, are you working to increase this, and what you think? You think that 30 rupees or 34 rupees is enough to maintain a person for a day or a family for a day?
Of course, this is a situation everywhere. There is no minimum wage is not mandatory in somewhere. So now we are going to amend the Minimum Wage Act. Minimum wage is mandatory. And also national floor level minimum wages. We are going to introduce national floor level minimum wages. Whether in the private sector and the government sector. And also contract labors. Now, minimum wages is different. Various states, different kind of the minimum wages are going on. Some states are giving 150 rupees. Some states are giving their minimum wages is 140, somewhere 300. My state is 300, more than 300. So different states, different minimum wages. Every different kind of the industries, they are fixing up their own minimum wages. So some industries they are giving 100 rupees. Some industries they are giving 140 rupees. Somewhere they are giving 75 rupees. This disparity is going everywhere. So therefore, Government of India has decided that this disparity should be removed, and also national floor level minimum wages should be introduced. That's why the present Minimum Wages Act we are going to amend and the bill is under consideration by Parliament. After passing the Minimum Wages Amendment Act, throughout the country there is a minimum wage that is mandatory to every establishment.
And you talked about that in Kerala, 300 rupees is there. In Manrega, people are getting 122 rupees. And that is the reason why fund allocated to different states are coming back. They are not utilizing it because they are not getting labor on that rate. Labor are not ready to work on that particular rate because they are getting higher rate from farmers or other companies. So that is the reason why I was asking that minimum wage should be implemented Kerala or Bihar. Why there should be difference? So your ministry is working something, things should be parallel. Are you working on this?
No, this Minimum Wages Act the Minimum Wage Amendment Act, we are planning to provide variable dearness allowance also.
Okay.
So
okay.
if minimum wages plus various dearness allowance,
right.
then the workers will get a reasonable wages.
Okay.
So the minimum wages plus various dearness
okay.
allowance
okay.
come
okay.
to